He must be very well aware of that database collection of I will say it's a data stored in any form, but that is database. It may be transactional data, it may be analytical data, it may be n number of text files that are stored. It is database. But when I use that database for the analytical purpose, and what does analytical means for me? The analytical mean for me is I want to have 10 years or I want to compare 10 years of finance record, or I want to compare 5 years of my sales record. If I want to compare it, I will go for a data warehouse which will automatically calculate and tell me that how much my sale was in last 5 years, how was my finance in last 10 years, and so on. Two types of modeling. One is called OLTP and one is called OLAP. OLTP means online transactional processing. Another one is OLAP, which is called online analytical processing. What is OLTP? When say you are using an ATM and you are in a day you have taken 3 transactions at the end of day, so every transaction will create one separate record, that in the first transaction you have taken this much amount, in the second transaction you have taken this much amount, and in third transaction you have taken whatever amount. 3 transactions are getting created in the database, but the end of day my requirement is in the entire region of New York how much the transaction happened. At that time I will sum up the entire transactions of the region New York, and that will reflect. I won't just say just that. Okay, that is online analytics. The difference between these two, the comparison between these two, is one is detailed, very much detailed. Okay, transaction processing is very much detailed, but when it comes to analytics, it is more knowledge providing. So here is a comparison between OLTP and data warehouse. It is written DW, which is data warehouse. It is same OLAP. First in data dependencies. Okay, what does mean by data dependencies? It means every, like I have given the example of an ATM, every transaction which you are doing over there is my data. It is having data dependency that it will each record is a proper transaction over there. Data warehouse, for data warehouse I need transaction processing, like I need a dimensional model. What is a dimensional model? I will explain in my like earlier slides. Just for this time I will say my data warehouse is dependent upon a database. In OLTP, I said it is a microscopic data consistency. What is microscopic means? Microscopic means each and every minute detail of the data is over there in OLTP. That at what time a transaction happened, how much amount a transaction happened, who is the user for the transaction, and all the microscopic details, whichever can affect me in the business. But in data warehouse, it is written global data consistency. I need our data at a level. Okay, if I need an data at regional level, say it like this. I need that how much yearly sales it is. I don't. When I say yearly sales, I doesn't mean that how the monthly how much was the monthly sales. How much I sold in January, how much I sold in February, how much I sold in March. It doesn't matter to me. When I go to yearly, I will just sum up everything, okay, and I will take it to yearly, and I will do the comparisons on yearly basis. In OLTP, there are. It is written that see millions of transactions per day. It can be n number of transactions in a day in a particular time. But in data warehouse, I need a particular information, a very specific piece of information at the time. That what the sum of all these over there. OLTP mostly doesn't keep history. Generally, see, as it is written millions of transactions per day and millions of transactions in a day, if happening to say, a finance company or an bank or anywhere. So keeping the history of this much number of records is not possible. So what we do, we generally archive the database and obviously we keep the information, but we archive it in storage media and we keep it and safe. So we keep a year's data or last 6 month data, this type of data only over there. But in data warehouse, keeping the history is necessary. That is a requirement of thing. Why it is requirement? Because we need to go in comparison that this year it was this, this year it was this, this year it was this, so it was a graph like this. This is my management. So data warehouse mainly required for management decisions. It is like all of my budgets and forecasts which will happen in the company, data depends upon my previous year data and previous year data warehouse. OLTP gets loaded in a day. So every time a transaction happens, that goes to an OLTP model, that goes to database. It is required, the entry goes to data warehouse now and then whenever you are doing a transaction. But in data warehouse, it doesn't, it is written gets loaded in a night, but it's not necessary in a night too. Means say it is the by frequency of data, I need a monthly report. So I don't need to be data loaded every night. I will I can do after 50 days or after say 29 or 30 days. That after 30 days entire data will sum up and get loaded to my data warehouse. It can be a case. If my data, I need to see a weekly report, so I will load the data weekly. If I need to see the daily report, so I can load the data at night once. So the basic difference what I mean to say in a data warehouse and a database, database is in continuous updating database. Continuous updating. It is every time we do a transaction, it goes to database. Every time it creates a particular entry over there. But when we move to data warehouse, we select then particular subject area. Now the term subject area means finance is in subject area, sales is in subject area, marketing is another subject area. So these are like my particular parameters over the management decisions. So every like I want to see sale, so it is my criteria. If my I want to see my finance, so it is another subject area. So this type I will divide my subject areas. If I will talk about only one subject area at a time, say finance only, I'm talking only about finance at a time, so that finance will be a data mart. So set of data marts, a particular subject area at a time is called data mart. So many data mart, collection of many data mart is in data warehouse. What is dimensional data modeling? So I will not go in the slide first. I will explain on the otherwise. It is like when I move from a transactional database to data warehouse, how much I there is a model we call dimensional modeling or dimension fact modeling. Okay, so what is dimension fact modeling? Dimensions over there are the data which generally don't change over the time or generally don't change frequently over the time. It may change over very slowly. It is like I'm having 10,000 records and after a year I'm having 11,000 records. It is increasing very slowly. Okay, but my what are my facts? It is the values which are getting inserted every night or after whatever the frequency of the data is, or like weekly, 50 days or a month. But it is these are the values. Okay, so again I go to the same example. Say in a month you have taken a single customer have taken 100 transactions through ATM, but I want the month record all at one time. So what I will do, I will take a time as an identity. Okay, I will take reason as an identity. Okay, say I'm having only two dimensions. So my time and my region, these are two dimensions. Now over these dimensions I will calculate it how much amount is withdrawn. Okay, so how that will be figured out? 2012 January New York, this much amount. Now it's not showing that which customer what he has done. It is just like I will like okay, so it will be like 2012 2013. Okay, and New York, and say this is the amount which is the transactions over in particular bank. Leave it. Okay, so then again it is 2012. Again same region, again there may be this much, there may be another record of another area, say New Jersey, and there may be this. So what is it is showing, if I am having only three records over there, so what is showing, I'm having time a dimension. Dimension is over which I will calculate a value. Okay, New York or New Jersey, these are my region, and over it I am calculating a value, and the value which is getting calculated is my fact. Okay, so when I move from an transactional database to my OLAP or data warehouse or data mart, I will say these are all synonymous. So when I will move to these, so I will calculate it in, I will dimension fact model. Okay, over here my dimensions are time, region, and this is the values which are getting calculated. This is my fact. We are discussing it right now. It's an all very pure theoretical, and this will be needed when we will be moving toward RPD and OBI or core concepts of it. Okay, so this session 1 and session 2 will be this session one is basically regarding the overview of these data warehouse and all schemas, type of schemas over there. In the second, we will discuss the OBI architecture, and in third, we will actually move to RPD and how we build it. Facts here are center dominant table. What is so everything is depend upon the value. Okay, so like over in the previous example, we are having the transactional amount as center value. Everything is depend upon this fact, this value. Reason, time itself, they are not having any if this value is not present over here, so this doesn't mean anything. 2012 New York, what does this mean? This doesn't mean anything unless and until I am not having this value over here. When the transactional amount is there, then I can say in 2013 my reason New York is having this much transactional amount. It is a central dominant table with which all the dimensions are connected. Okay, how the connections happen? There are two type of schemas that we will go in the slides and we will check out in later section. Okay, second one is multi-part primary key. How it is multi-part? Like it will be like a fact is how the fact is connected to a dimension. There will be an ID of dimension table which will be present in fact table. Okay, like time ID, I will having for every single month. If I am having monthly data, for every single month I will be having one key in the fact table. Say I am having 2012 January, and for that 2012 January I am having an ID 201. So that 201 ID will be present in fact table with the name of time ID. So when 201 will be get compared to 201, so fact and data, fact data will get populated with the same month of dimension data. Fact holds million and billion of records because it is, as I told you earlier, that dimensions are slowly populating tables, but facts are not slowly getting populated tables. It gets a value every now and then. The frequency is decided. It may be night, it may be a week, it may be 15 days or a month, whatever be the frequency will be at the at that level, it will get the n number of records all of a sudden. Links directly to the dimensions. Dimensions are linked to facts. Facts are linked to dimensions. Stores business measures. Business measures are dimensions. And it's saying stores business measures. Measures are values. Like transaction amount is a value. In our previous example, if I'm talking about the sales, then my sales will be the measure, how much sales is done. If I will talk about the units, how much units sold, so my units sold was a measure over there. So the calculated value, the actual value will be a measure, and the fact stores that only. And constantly varying data, it is continuously increasing. It is like it is saying holds millions and billions of records, and with the frequency, like I'm populating the data every night, so every night this much number of records are getting in to the that table. So it is the same, it is saying constantly varying. It's very constant, very constant. Dimension on the other hand, it's all very different from the fact. Dimensions are single join to fact table. Okay, dimension has a primary key that facts hold that key as an foreign key, and the both tables fact and dimension has a primary foreign join over there. Okay, it may be inner join, it may be outer join, depending upon the condition which required over there. So if like I just given the example of time and time dimension table and the fact which we was discussing, that there will be a time ID which will be stored in the fact with the same name. I will again to go to the example how this dimension will happen. Leave this my dimension table. Say I am having the dimension table with the name dimension time, dim time, dim underscore time. So how the my columns of this will be, columns will be say time ID, month, year, month, year, quarter, quarter, date format, okay, say there are some columns like these, and what my fact contains, fact, say I'm having fact of sales, okay, I will say it like this only, fact sales. So this will have dim time ID over here. Say it's having an sales ID within a definite record. Okay, this is having some more dimension connected to it. So I will say it dim one ID, dim two ID. Okay, so now it's having actual data of sales units, sales amount. Okay, so now this time ID is present over here. Actually it is in a primary key to dim time and present as a foreign key to fact sales. Okay, so, and I'm having two different dimensions also, dim 1 ID and dim 2 ID. This may be anything, like say there is a reason also, and there is one more dimension as reason, and this is having reason ID over here. Okay, so this reason ID will get connected to that another dimension that will be dim reason over there. Say and now I'm having a sales ID. This may be there is a table with the sales name with the, so this can get connected to that. Over this example, time ID is here, time ID is here. So when these two tables will get connected, this will be connected over time ID. Okay, now what this is my fact table. This is having measurable amount, some sales amount over here, sales units over here, these are measurable quantity, but in my dimension table there is not measurable quantities. These are year, month, quarter, these type of values. These are not actually measurable. They are not measures. They are a this is a data over which calculations can be done. Okay, so it was an example to explain. Okay, stores business attributes. Business attributes, if I am having an a reason as an dimension, so it will store say country name, state name, particular area name. So it over which I will calculate some fact. So it stores the business information of about the data which need to be calculated. Attributes are textual in nature. Textual, I mean over here, I mean that they are like more or less are fixed. Okay, it may like I can take the example of time dimension. If I'm talking about the today, so I'm having month till October 13. Okay, so my data in the dimension table will be till October 13 only. But as in when the month will grows to November, December or next year, okay, so my my time dimension also grow, but it is not growing at the level of the fact is growing. It is just like we are entering one record every month. It doesn't affect the database. What affect the database is millions of records all at the same time. Okay. Organized into hierarchies. Okay. Hierarchy itself says it's a parent-child relationship. Okay. How the hierarchies work? In a time dimension, what the hierarchy would be? Year, the child of the year, quarter, the child of the quarter will be month, and the child of the month, it may be week. Okay. This is an hierarchy. So when and how hierarchies come in picture? So if I'm watching it data and it's having like yearly sum of data I'm looking at. Okay, I can just if I want to just expand the year and I want to see the data quarter wise. So I will just, there will be an say 2013 it is written. I will just click on the plus sign there on 2013. It will say me give me quarterly data. Again, I will expand any quarter. It will give me monthly data. So this is how the data structure flows. Year to quarter, quarter to month. So this is example of time hierarchy. There may be product hierarchy. So it may be like there is a product class, then there is a product category. So I can see a company is there which generally sells sanitary products. So there is a class bath accessories. If you click on the bath accessories, there are classes of those bath accessories. It may be showers, it may be taps, and you are having seeing the data over that class. So this is how the hierarchies flows from parent to child, from this is parent-child relationship. Okay, more or less constant data, as we just talked about this, that more or less in a database, if we are having hundreds of record monthly or say 100 or a low number of set data is entering to the database, it doesn't affect the database. Database is in itself is a very vast thing to handle the data. So tens of record or hundreds of record doesn't affect it. So the dimensions are very slowly changing. Okay, so examples which the slide has taken, these are time, that is in dimension. Product, which we just discussed, is a dimension. Customer can be a dimension. Store can be a dimension. Reason can be a dimension. So these are the criterias on which we are calculating the data. So these are dimensions. Okay, moving ahead with it. When a fact is connected to a dimension, there are two types of schemas. One is star schema. Another one is snowflake schema. Okay, what is star schema and what is snowflake schema? Star itself says there is a particular identity in the center, and many another identities are connected to that center identity. Or what is my center identity over here? it is fact. And what are other identities which are connected to it? These are dimensions. Okay. If a fact is connected to multiple dimensions, it is called fact dimension modeling. And it is, if it is connected in the star type, the fact at a center and dimensions are connected to fact. Dimensions are not connected to one another. Okay, fact, if I am having three dimensions, say product, reason, time, and these are connected to a table named fact sales. Fact sales is connected to time. Fact sales is connected to reason. Fact sales is connected to product. So this is a star schema. Okay. There are two things written over here. Fact surrounded by 4 to 15 dimensions. It may be 2 to 15. Okay. Dimensions are denormalized. Okay. One thing I wanna know. Are you aware about the concepts of normalizing and denormalizing?
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
Soma, I'm not able to hear you. Are you aware of the concepts of normalizing and denormalizing?
Yes.
Okay. Then it's fine. So generally data warehouse data is denormalized data. This is not a normalized data. Why? Because it has a redundancy. Like in the previous example over here. Okay, that example I just closed. Like we was having an data like 2013 January the transaction amount, 2013 February the transaction amount. So 2013 is all together repeating for the 12 times. But my normalization says that I shouldn't have any redundancy over there. But this that is good for the storage purpose. But for the retrieval purpose, when I want a fast retrieval over a data warehouse, then I will keep the data in the form like I can fetch it directly. Okay, so that generally we keep in denormalized form. So it is saying that dimensions are denormalized. It we keeps in denormalized form. Next is snowflake star schema with secondary dimensions. If say I'm having a dimension product 1 and it is having 50 columns in it, but 50 columns are not required all at a certain. Only 10 columns are required to me at one instant, and rest 40 are required in very specific cases, not generally. So what I will do, I will keep an structure like my fact is connected to dimension which is product 1, and that product 1 dimension is further connected to a dimension product 2. Okay, so it is like fact to dimension to dimension. So this type of hierarchy when goes, this is called snowflake. Generally we avoid this. We don't entertain snowflaking in RPD. Why we don't entertain? Because when my database, my query, answers query is hitting the database which is in star snowflake schema, the performance is very poor. It the retrieval of the query it's not good in the snowflake. So we don't use snowflake. We try to indulge everything in star and try to cover up that star the entire repository with the star schema only. Okay. Star schema with secondary dimension. Okay, that's what we said, that product 1 is in primary dimension. It's having a secondary dimension named product 2. Second, don't snowflake for saving space. Snowflaking doesn't save space. Second, third one is snowflake if secondary dimensions have many attributes. That's what we was discussing. That if snowflaking generally happen when there are more number of tables in the dimension and we just snowflake it, but that is not an like good option. We can use another options too. There we will discuss it out later. Okay, so here is an example over here. So see, as we are discussing about this only, dimension table is having a key one which is connected to a fact table key one over here. Okay, second table is here key two, which is connected to key two over here. Key three of the dimension table three is connected here, and key four of connected over here. Oh, if you see it in the fact table, it's written over data columns, data columns, data columns over here, but it's not written over here that it is these are data columns. These are not data columns. There is no data in the dimension tables. These are attributes over which we consider the value. Okay, data is in fact table only. This is an example of star schema. Okay, moving ahead, this is an real example. Earlier it was an demo. This is a real example over here. So in product, there is a product code which is connected to sales over here. In the period, year, quarter, month, day, okay, this one is connected over here. Okay, and what this means, that we also I will let you know. Star code, this one store code is over connected to here. So what this mean? This mean one store, this is one is to many relationship. So one store code which is present over here has multiple entries over here. So this represent one is to many relationship. This example is made depending upon OBI 10G. so in OBI 11G, these lines and this these representations are a bit different, but we will discuss it. There is no issue with it. So like in this example, we are having three dimensions, okay, and one fact table in between. Now my fact table is having unit sold, dollar cost. So actually some measurable figures are over there. Okay, moving ahead, this is in snowflaking. My fact table is here. It is connected to store dimension with an key. That store dimension is having a district ID which is connected to, and district ID which is region, which is connected to region. So with one fact, there is an one dimension which further connected to a dimension which is further connected to a dimension. So this is all which is this is all which is happening in snowflaking. Ultimately this is only fact, and these all are connected to this only, but via this to this, this to this, and this to this. Okay. Next, data mart, data warehouse, and ODS. Okay. So what data mart says, organize around a single business process. As I told you, that there, if there is only one subject area, like only sales, there is a subject area only marketing, with ongoing entire process. So it will say a data mart. It will be having only single business process. Second, represent small part of organization's business. It obviously, if it is in single business process, it will not cover the entire business. Third, logical subset of complete data warehouse. Right, if I'm having a data mart, I will connect multiple data marts. It will contain a take me to a warehouse. So data mart is very small part of actual warehouse. Faster rollout, but business integration in long run. Faster, why it is saying faster rollout? Because I need to concentrate over only one identity at a time. There is not required to go in separate identity and interlinking of them. I just need to concentrate. If I'm looking toward and marketing, I need to look into the marketing only. I need not to check the what my marketing is doing with the sales, or marketing is how it is related to budget. So I don't require that. Actually, I need to concentrate over on the marketing in the data mart, and I'm just concentrating over the same. Second is data warehouse. That is union of the constituent data marts. Queryable source of data in organization requires extensive business modeling, may take years to design and build. So as one business process is very complex process, so generating invoices to actual cash delivery or whatever product delivery. So if we want to capture everything in data warehouse, it's actually start from data modeling, which we was discussing it a part of data modeling only. It starts with data modeling and it goes to actual query. Okay, so when we combine many data marts, it form a data warehouse. Okay, so data warehouse is the complete, it represent an organization, it can represent the entire organization in one go. Third one is ODS, it's operational data store. What is operational data store means? Point of integration for operational system, low level decision support, and can store integrated data but at detailed level. From a transactional data, what transaction data actually is? I'm picking a text file, I'm picking see n number of data sources. From n number of data sources, when I'm generating an detailed actual detailed source, that is I say operational data store. From operational data store, I will generate an data warehouse. That is an intermediate state between transaction and data warehouse. ODS is generally considered as transactional data only. OLAP we discussed. Additive, semi-additive, and non-additive fact, factless facts. These are things which we will discuss in as we move forward with architecture. Next, we will discuss about the architecture of OBI, and we will these are the general concepts. What we will discuss, there was nothing about OBI. These are the very general concepts and very upper framework of it. Next, we will discuss the actual framework of OBI, the architecture, and in the third, we will start with OBI. This is the my design of approach toward an OBI study.